Welcome back. I'm Strong Side alongside my boy Onset. How's it going?
I'm doing good, man. I'm running out of breath, though. I mean, the Halo we have seen today, I'm on the verge of collapsing.
The 49,
I mean, it's been ridiculous.
49 match.
What
you
did
guys
you think
had.
Of it?
I couldn't believe it. I was sitting over back in the trailer watching on my cell phone, literally coughing my food up like, no way this is happening right now. I thought Immunity was going to take it. They were so close, neck and neck. It looked like Denial was going to pull away. And it was just kill for kill. Like, once they got to 40 kills, it seemed like just kill for kill the entire way through. But who had the sniper? Both teams were scared, but Immunity was afraid to push. I think the camo sat up for a good 2 minutes. No joke.
It was tempting people. It was like the bit of candy that were just both teams looking at it going, I know this could win us the game, but it could also lose us the game. And ultimately, that's
crazy.
What happened?
It was literally up for a minute, and then the game went to the end, and then went to overtime, and it still sat up. It was crazy.
It's crazy. I mean,
absolutely.
I've got to say, I'm a big fan of how these non-NA teams have come over and competed so far. They have. I don't know what your views on it are, but they have turned up and played.
You know, it's awesome to see just the teams from across the world just really show up and put up a fight against all these NA teams.
Yeah.
Because I mean, history has shown NA teams have normally been dominant, but I mean, now that is not the case. It's awesome to see EU teams, Australian teams, just teams from all over the world really proving that they are still a force to be reckoned with and still can make it to the top eight.
And it's the Halo World Championship, man, and world is the bit that I love. And speaking of Halo World Championships and a bit of swag that we've got to show these guys at home, we've got to give
Let's check it out. Massive thanks
to Jinx for some of these wonderful shirts that, as you can see here, wonderfully displayed
with
by myself.
Patch, with the nice patch up here for the Halo World Championship 2016.
I want to see if I can get myself one of these, man. They look pretty sweet to me.
Yeah, this one's got to have your name on it.
I mean, this one doesn't have any name on it, so thank you very much.
Yeah,
that'll be coming home. We won't talk about it.
But yeah, we've got a big match coming up next. It's going to be Fab versus Elevate. Another solid match, I would say. Both teams, I consider, of equal skill. Fab fought their way through the EMEA regionals. They were actually not predicted to even make it here. Mm. They've got quite the story. They actually took down the top dogs, Dignitas, in a crazy fashion. Everyone was going nuts. Literally everyone left the main stage area and went over to the side station and was just watching this match because nobody could believe that one of the top teams, Dignitas, which some say was the second best team in all EU Halo.
They played second at Gfinity, the UK LAN finals. And they just didn't even make it. I mean, it was unbelievable. And you've been lucky enough to be at every stage of Fabi's journey so far. You were there at they weren't at the UK LAN finals because German strong side, aren't they?
They were at the EMEA regionals. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So you were lucky enough to be there and obviously see that Dignitas story play out.
There's so much emotion in that series.
There's
too.
A video on YouTube if you look it up. I've never seen a squad just look so devastated. Just absolutely like having their dreams snatched away from them. But they're at home. Fabi are here. And they're here to play. And there's some great players on this squad.
And you know, another thing to note, Moe's from Dignitas is here coaching Fab.
He managed to find his way over somehow.
He's trying to support his old squad into a victory here. Correct me if I'm wrong. Moe's did team with the guys on Fab and left to team with the Dignitas guys.
Yep.
And now has returned back to Fab to coach the team.
Yeah, that's absolutely correct. And to say, well, I mean, he thought that it was a better opportunity for him to, you know, maybe get out here to Worlds. He saw Dignitas as being his squad to achieve things with. But as you say, it did not work out that way. But it's good of Fabi to have him back on board here. He's going to bring, you know, maybe some of the experience that he's learned from the other players around him in the EU scene, like Respectful, who's obviously been over to the States. He's learned a lot. So hopefully if he can add that to Fabi's lineup, that could definitely be effective for them in this series.
And then at the other end of the spectrum, we have Elevate.
We've got
a calm mentality and a swift kill who have been in the scene for quite some time, followed by Rain and Penguin. People really hype up Penguin as well, being one of the main slayers on the squad. But swift kill, he has time and time shown and proven to so many people that he has just got what it takes. I consider him an all-around player. He does it all. He doesn't care about your stats. He's just focused on the win, and those are my favorite type of players.
Yeah.
When someone just literally gives it their all, they may be leading the charge, they may give their life up, and at the end of the game, their stats may not show everything that they did, but if you're a top caliber player, you know that that person is putting in the work and putting in the time to create that victory for the team and doing the dirty work, as you would say.
Exactly. It's players like that that will make players like Penguin shine. If you see Penguin have a crazy game where he's walking around, say, with a sniper and he's not getting shot at anything, it's all because of players like Calm and Swiftkill. They are creating the opportunities. They are letting him do his thing. So it's one thing that's never talked about, but it is one thing that is massively appreciated at the top level of Halo. If you're one of those players, you are very much valued on your team.
Definitely. Well, let's take a look at the Elevate squad and see who we've got on their team. We've got Rain, Penguin, Swiftkill, and Calm Mentality. These guys qualified through the NA qualifiers, getting 5th through 8th. They had some pretty good matches over at the NA qualifiers, and they did fall short, but you know what? Practice makes perfect. They practiced quite a bit going into this event. They were previously known as Noble Esports, but now under the sponsorship of Elevate. These guys, their keys to victory. Penguin needs to outslay Speed. We saw Speed just do work with the sniper. If Penguin can be the main slayer of the squad and shut him down, these guys will be fine. And then, of course, a Calm Mentality. You're here at the Halo World Championships. A lot is on the line, but you gotta stay calm, stay focused.
Yeah, absolutely. So as you can see there, Elevate, they look ready to go. And I tell you what, Mike, I'm ready to go as well. I just can't wait to get into this series. But it's gonna be down to players like Swiftkill and to keep Penguin alive, to let him do his thing, as we've previously mentioned. So it's gonna be interesting to see how Elevate can perform in this series. But FabE, they're the team that I really wanna have a look at.
Yeah, let's take a look at FabE here. We've got Doodle, Kimbo, Monkey, and Speed.
Yeah, now Doodle, Kimbo, Monkey, and Speed. Speed especially. He is the flashiest sniper in all of Europe at the moment. The guy is crazy. You were lucky enough to be at the EMEA finals where you saw him absolutely going off with that weapon. He was no-scoping. He was quick-scoping. He was doing it all. But one player I need to give a massive shout-out to on this team is Doodle. He did one of the player profiles that's on the Halo YouTube. And we learned a little bit about him, and he is the filler player, like we say. He's all about the W, but their keys to victory, give Speed the sniper. It's as simple as that. Let him do his thing. Doodle, he needs to be the leader for this squad, as you previously mentioned, and make sure that they do not die one by one. Make sure that they're pushing together as a squad and executing their plans.
And we can say that time and time over and over again. Players, don't go off on your own and die by yourself. This is all about teamwork. Once you get to this top caliber, if I could speak, these guys need to use so much teamwork to have that gap between the other team. But let's take a look at the series layout here. We're gonna start off with Coliseum CTF. You know what? Speed's gonna go straight for that sniper. I bet he is just gonna start taking faces early on, followed by the Rig Team Slayer, Eden Strongholds, Truth CTF, and Plaza Team Slayer.
Now, speaking to Fabi before this series earlier on, these first three game types, they are feeling so, so confident. These are three of their best game types. Collie Flag, love it. Slayer Rig, love it. Any maps that they can give Speed the Sniper, they can work around them, they love it. They are feeling really, really confident this series, which is exactly what I want to see from them coming up against a team like Elevate. They don't fear them.
Not at all.
Again, Speed's one of these players we talked about earlier. He doesn't mind who he's playing against. He's going to do his thing. He's going to no-scope. He's going to try to hit
the no-scopes cross-map that we saw at EMEA Regionals were absurd. No joke, it felt like we were watching a European Royal 2.
Yeah, it's exactly that. It's not an overstatement either. It was insane.
There was no overkills, but the multi-kills that were happening were just absolutely absurd. I'm sure you can watch them somewhere online. The EMEA Regional highlights reel or something like that. It's got to be out there. But Speed, just an incredible player all around. I think we're going to see a lot from him. I think it's gonna be about controlling those power-ups, power weapons here in Coliseum CTF, and really keeping on the other end of the spectrum, keeping that sniper out of Speed's hands. The Elevate needs to have Penguin. We've said that. Outslay the other team, but it's not just about outslaying, it's really controlling the objective as well and moving that at the same time. It's not all about the slays. You got to start moving flags. You get two or three down, get a guy in the base. Start slowly moving the flag. Sometimes we'll see teams completely forget about the flag and not begin to move it. And uh, When we look at two teams like this, though, I feel like we're going to be seeing a lot of 50-yard line battles, both teams trying to fight to get into each other's base. We're going to have to see who can be the more aggressive team. And actually, just real quick, we are watching these guys warm up right now, and I just saw Speed hit a no-scope cross map already from Snipe Cave to jumped up over to a guy coming up the snipe ramp.
I hope he just doesn't use them all up before the game starts proper. You know what I mean? I don't want him to be hitting these ridiculous shots right now and then get into game one and he starts whiffing. But, I mean, we can see, luckily from our point of view, what's happening in this warm-up game as we have a quick look at Denial here, who are getting ready to get into this game. Mike, I'm excited. I want to get this game underway. I don't like waiting anymore.
Who do you think's going to win on set? Big question here.
Do you know what? I actually predicted that Fabi would get out of this group. So that's a big call. It's a big call. And I am going to go, I think we're going to see the first game 5 of the day. And I think Fabi are going to take it 3-2.
3-2. 3-2 in favor of Fabi. All
right. Out.
I'm going to go Elevate 3-1. You know why? Because they have the new coach added to their squad, Chig.
Yes,
Chig
they
is
do.
Coaching
it's
Elevate.
A big factor.
So he's a big factor. He brings a lot of knowledge to this team, and even when it comes down to just telling a player to stay alive or telling a player when to push because another teammate could be pushing, just helping them work together. I think that's going to be a big key to success for this squad here. So Chig's going to make a big impact. Elevate 3-1. But for everyone at home, be sure to tweet at HCS. Tweet us who you think's going to win. Hashtag HaloWC. Hashtag the team you think's going to win, and let us know.
I think the thing of Chig as well, he's the same. He's very calming presence. It's the same thing we saw in the last series with Denial. Alumni, very calming presence. Doesn't get overexcited. Keeps things simple. Will talk to the players like they need to. So he's definitely going to be a big factor in this match. But they got the man there in the background. We saw him, Mose. And Mike, you, talking of Mose, you probably were lucky enough to commentate on one of the biggest plays we've seen at Halo WC and involving that man. That ninja we saw.
That ninja with
that ninja
the flag.
With the flag. I mean, insane.
But now we've got Fab on the red side and Elevate representing the blue team here. We're going to hop on board with Rain to start off this match here and see what power weapon they're going to go for. If Rain is going to pick up the DMR, he's going to be tagged along with a teammate alongside him going up to Rockets already. Taking that little ledge up there to get a nice angle. He's get some team help. Rain is going to be taken down though. But you know what? Penguin is going to get control of those Rockets. So let's hop on board with him real quick as he's already moving in to Fab E's base right now. Looking for a guy in the cave. Can't spot him. The guy is still hiding in the cave, I suspect. Penguin just looking, not able to get him. He's going to miss a Rocket.
Oh,
Pucket
no!
Rocket. So many Pucket Rockets this event.
Oh, set. No. The Rocket was missed. The flag is actually being moved here by Fab E. So Monkey is the man with the Rockets in his back pocket right now. Misses, actually does connect with that Rocket, putting the player to one shot, and he's doing a great job of just traversing at the moment. That flag is actually being run home by Speed, but he's actually taken down by Calm right on the spot. So that flag is sat there right now, and Fab E, they're 1-0 up straight away. The European boys are bringing it today, Mike.
First minute with the cap, Speed moving it across the map extremely fast. Speed, normally known to be the sniper, showing that he can do the objective work too when he needs to. He ran that flag and rallied it all the way back, all the way to the flag stand, allowing his teammate to pick up the kill. Doodle picking
up
a big kill on Calm Mentality. Looking for the double kill. Can he get it? Nope. He's going to get tag team and taken down. Let's hop on board with Penguin, though, who's looking to pick up a couple kills. He's going to get scattered in the face by Kimbo. Speed does have the sniper, though. Let's see what he's going to do with it. Goes for a few no-scopes. Not going to connect. Maybe he used up a little juice too much there in the warm-up, but I'm sure we're going to see a lot more coming from him.
We've got the curse of the caster as well. Every single screen I go to, players are dying, but Duda's going to go up against Calm here, so we are on the point of view of Calm. Penguin picks up a kill on Kimbo. Rain picks up the kill on Speed. Doodle doing a great job just making sure. This is what I mean. I love plays like that from Doodle. Made him work so hard for that kill. But all of a sudden, just like that, Elevate picking up kills as they need to. But Monkey comes in to search that one down as we see some settings being adjusted there by the Fabi players. And Swift Kill now with that DMR, he's going to be putting some pressure onto the base of Fabi.
All right, let's actually hop on board with Doodle, who is pushing over to the snipe side of the map right now. He's alone right now, just waiting for a teammate, playing this nice and slow. He doesn't need to force this right now. He knows two players are at snipe. He's waiting for a teammate. There's Monkey. Looks like they're going to tag team. Actually, no. He's going to leave. Very weird play right there by Doodle. He saw Monkey come over. He saw him come into his screen, but he ended up switching and going towards the fountain instead of pushing with Monkey. That's honestly, I'd say a big error on Doodle's part right there. He needs to push with Monkey, as his teammate was right there to help him, and he knew two players were at snipe. But now Elevate turning the tides, trying to get a flag back to their base. He's got two players giving him some cover, ground pounding all the way back to the found. Looks like he's going to get it in. Can he cap it? Yes, he does. He's going to tie this game up 1-1.
Yeah, great play from Rain there. Picked up that initial double kill. Knew there was a player below him, but has decided to pick up that objective and run it straight away. So great play for him, as we see Speed has just picked up a sniper rifle on the Fabby side. So I'd like to go over to him and see what he's going to be able to do at the moment. He's actually taken down off screen, so we'll stay on board with Rain and see what he can do. He's pushing across the map now, top catwalk. He's trying to find a player below him. Does have that SMG to give him a hand in those close quarter battles. I think one of the players is actually Doodle. We give him the runaround at the moment, round the blue maze, as we put some great shots down on Monkey. He's aware that those shot, the rockets are coming up, sorry, at the top of the rockets as he drops down now. That's two kills now for Rain. And last time we saw Rain pick up a double kill, he initiated a flag cap for his squad.
And look at the maneuvering that Rain has been doing. He's dropping down, clambering back up to the bridge. Some people say dropping down from the bridge like that is not a good call, but you know what? He was helping out his team. Picks up a big kill there on Doodle right now. It's still Rain just staying alive here. Can he stay alive? Nope. He's going to get taken down by the BR, or excuse me, a grenade at the BR. Swift kill is going to take his place here. Looking to pick up Kimbo. Not going to be able to pick up Kimbo. Elevate really controlling the snipe side of the map and controlling that top bridge. We haven't seen Elevate really to get control until right now. Let's see if they can keep control of this, as Monkey looks like he's going to make a flank in here, but by doing so, he's going to block the spawns here at Elbow. So they're going to spawn over in Cave. We just saw a player spawn into the cave. Monkey needs to be aware that his teammates are dying, and he is the only one. He just needs to stay alive as long as he can, but he is taken down. Swift kill now with Rockets in a prime position to make a move. He's going to pick up a kill on Kimbo. Big kill for Swift kill, but he's taken down.
Now Calm is actually managing to push into the red base as those rockets are finally going to be taken out of action. So Calm trying to put some pressure on the Fabby side, but Speed is aware of that and manages to clean him up. So Doodle now, he's going to be coming off the respawn with that lovely Fry's pistol skin, which I'm a big fan of myself. And Rain actually kills a player with the rocket launcher, so the power and seal seem to be in the hands of Elevate. But Doodle, as I mentioned before, he is the glue player for this Fabby squad, and he's going to be the one pushing it aggressively now as Kimbo picks up a kill with that splinter nade. That's another kill in the hands of Fabby, so that's two down now as Doodle desperately trying to push in. That's three down now, and the last player is the live top snipe. Doodle doing a great job to stay alive. The flag is actually being moved as well by Fabby. I can't actually see who that is. Gotta pick up this kill here,
and he's going to be taken down. Actually, he is able to finish the kill right there. We just saw that on death screen. Kimbo running the flag in. Looks like they're going to get this one to get solidify this to 2-1. Fabby takes the lead on set.
Unbelievable. This is what I mean about Fabby. They are a great squad, and they're one of those squads who anyone who sleeps on them, they will make them pay. Kimbo is a player who loves to flank as well. As we see here, picks up one kill, picks up a second kill. This is going to be a huge kill from Kimbo, stopping that flag run with the scattershot player in front of him. Triple kill for Kimbo. Great play from him. And oh my words, Mike, strong side. Fab looking really, really good right now.
Yeah, these guys are keeping up the pressure, and not only that, they have everyone picking up the power weapons as well. Speed gets the rocket, picks up a kill. He's got to be weary of the sniper player, or excuse me, the sniper rifle though. It was picked up. I don't know if I like this play by Speed though. Going into your courtyard, it's such an open area. There's so many sight lines to look at that courtyard area at your base. You don't really want to take a power weapon there. You want to try and take it into bottom middle and move to a more safe and secure spot on the map. He's going to lose rockets though. And I think, actually, did Speed get rockets back? Yes, he did. He has two rockets, or excuse me, picks up a double kill, still has a rocket in the chamber. He's getting some nades, looking to pick up a kill over here. On the rocket side of the map, picks up the double,
the triple kill
right there, following his teammate kill. We're going to count that as a triple anyway. Sometimes you accidentally kill your teammate for a triple, for an overkill. You know what? Sometimes it's worth it. Speed thought that was worth it. He's going to try and stay alive here in the cave. Can he pick up Swift Kill? Not going to be able to. Swift Kill says no. Picks up a big kill. Now we're on board with Penguin, looking to solidify the cap for cap number two to tie up the game 2-2. We are tied here. Fabby versus Elevate tied 2-2 in the match. 4.5 minutes left. One cap remaining.
Yeah, and Penguin managed to sneak into the Fabi base there and run that one across Rocket Side. Picks up a no-scope on Speed. Speed usually known for being the one to be no-scoping, not being no-scoped. Penguin showing why he is one of the players that has been hyped up so much during this competition. And all of a sudden, the pressure is coming from Elevate. Rain picking up a double kill. The flag is moving, and this looks set up for a potential flag cap as a great body shot there on Doodle from Penguin. Khan picks up that kill on Doodle. The flag is still moving across the bomb grass, but a couple of kills seem to be going down. This is do or die right now for Fabi in game one. They need to make great plays here. This flag has been stopped, I believe, as the beatdown comes in from Penguin. The brawler medal comes in with those knuckle dusters, but I think that flag is actually going to be returned home. Great defensive stand from Fab.
So, Onsen, I want to comment on that. It looked like Elevate had completely secured that cap. You even said they're perfectly set up. They have a sniper top bridge. They have a player at the BR. They're running flag off the bridge. There was a player running up their side rockets. But the flag runner just jumped the flag out to bottom middle. He needed to get into some secure area right there. Normally, players run the flag to BR and go up to the bridge, but we did not see that. Calm not getting a grenade kill here with those two rockets. We're seeing a lot of wild rockets here. Top-tier players just, I guess, really making it hard to hit those rockets, but Doodle picking up a kill, and now we're down to 3:10. A lot of time left. Sniper is coming up, and just to give you some insight, Sniper does spawn every 3 minutes. So players are on top of that. You'll see the timer on your screen show up. Once it gets in within 30 seconds of the weapon spawn, rockets do spawn every 2 minutes. So a lot of power weapons constantly coming up on this map, and you need to make sure you're getting control of them.
And I love what Doodle's doing here. He is constantly holding forward across the map. He's putting shots on every single player that's in his way. Penguin finally puts him down, but he did so much damage while moving aggressively across the map there. But Monkey has actually got that sniper rifle in his hands, as we see on death screen. Doodle, we're going to stay with Doodle through the respawn because I like what he was doing before. But Elevate now with the aggression coming. Mike, you've seen something. Please take it away, my friend.
We were talking about the keys to victory, about not dying one by one. We're seeing the players on Fab really kind of become very individual with their gameplay right now. They're fighting 1v1 battles. Yes, you're going to fight 1v1 battles sometimes, but you should not be always fighting 1v1 fights. You're going to see Speed win a nice 1v1 there, but in the midst of all of that happening, Calm is able to get the flag in the base and solidify cap number 3 to win game number 1.
I mean, we love close games here, don't we, on B-Stream? 3-2 first game again? I mean, what? I don't know what the guys on B-Stream have had for breakfast, but every single game is close.
Let's go hashtag hype B-Stream. If you're
B-Stream,
in the Twitch chat,
B-Squad.
B-Squad for life. Hype up the B-Stream. We love you guys. Thanks for watching us over here. Not missing a beat of action here at the Halo World Championship. You see Calm Mentality on your screen. All smiles right now. You know what's interesting? We saw Fab in the lead at the start of that game. It was looking good for him. And then that seems kind of to be the story of all the games here. But let's take a quick look at the stats right here. Rain, 26 kills.
Wow.
Throwing down some big numbers for his squad. Slaying people so no one can stop a flag run. And they honestly, Elevate really just capitalized once they got a few players down. They didn't need to get all four down. They just got a couple players down, and then they made that flag run. But on the other end, Fab really just turning into a solo play style. Later in the match, they started so strong and it was looking so good for them. They have to stay in that team mindset. They have to work together, and it's hard. You got to communicate, like, Onset, let's push. Let's go over to Sniper. Let's push together. And you have to constantly be on that. So I want to see those guys really pick that teamwork and their communication back up coming into game 2.
And one thing to point out as well, we hyped up Speed at the start of that series. He has to go off if Fabi is going to take that. He had a bit of a rough game there. It wasn't the worst game in the world, but usually he's the one putting up stats like we saw from Rain there. So he's going to have to pick his game up a little bit. We did see a huge play of that triple kill from Kimbo, which got the flag return as well on the scattershot player. Great plays from him. Fabi, they can definitely match up against this Elevate team. We've just seen it there. But as you say, Mike, it's all about composure. It's all about concentration and playing till the last moment of the game. They went up in the game. They were confident. But then as soon as the pressure started coming on them, that was when they started to fall apart and they didn't believe in each other as much. But you got it nailed on. If they do that, they stick together. There's no reason why they can't take this series right down to game 5.
Exactly. So let's take a look at the series coming up here. We're going to have game number 2 coming underway here soon. We've got game number two, which is going to be Slayer on the rig. We've seen a lot of different ways this is played. We saw CLG play this game type a lot faster than other teams have been playing throughout the tournament. And then on the other end of the spectrum, we saw Epsilon play the rig Slayer in a complete lockdown status. Literally just snipe drone, sitting back with the sniper, and Bux and Jimbo creating that wall, really making it almost like the old school lockout team Slayer or lockdown team Slayer, where you just hold down one side of the map. But when we saw CLG, it was just like, no, we're in your face. We're going to charge you. There's nothing you can do. It doesn't matter if you're holding back, playing defensive. It doesn't matter if you're putting aggressiveness on us. We are just going to shut you down. So I'm interested to see how these two teams play this. I haven't seen them play Rig Slayer yet. So, I mean, anything could happen.
If it's anything like we just saw in the last series between Immunity and Denial, 49-49 overtime, I'm happy. You know, it's simple as that. If it goes like that game did, I wouldn't be surprised if we did see a 49-49 as well, because all of these teams just seem to want to give us the closest games possible. But we've got Monkey on the screen there. There is Doodle, the man himself, the calm presence and the captain. I don't know if he's actually the captain, but he's sort of the in-game captain for Fabi. He calls the shots, he makes the plays. So he's going to be very important to this Fabi squad if they want to bring this series back to 1-1. But it is currently 1-0 to Elevate, and we're going to start this one off with Rain, the man who put up the most kills in the last game.
All right, he's going to start by picking up the Plasma Caster here. Looks, I want to say Camo was burned, possibly. Speed does have the sniper as Rain is putting on some pressure, allowing Speed to possibly pick up a snipe kill here. There is a player in top tower. A lot of pressure coming in from Elevate, though, to collapse on those players in that back corner. What a move by Rain right there to stay alive, still staying alive. I thought he was going to fall off the map there. No, he doesn't. He uses ground pound to stay on the map. Not in a very good position, though, right here. Yeah, he did stay alive, but there wasn't much he was doing as his teammates were fighting players over in the back corner. And now Kimbo does have sniper. If we could hop on board with him, Kimbo in the prime position to pick off some faces. No one should ever come through that hall right there where he's looking when the other team has the sniper. That is the prime time location for players to just get picked off constantly. He's going to pick up a body shot on a player, but he's going to be taken down by Penguin. Penguin's probably going to get this sniper. Yes, he does. Looking to pick up a double kill, not going to be able to. Good job on just leaving that kill there. Actually, Monkey fell off the map, so Penguin does pick up that kill. Still a two-kill game right now. Penguin has the sniper in the prime position, but still, this hasn't been locked down yet. It's only 9-8. Both teams are still putting a bit of pressure on each other. No team really able to lock down the half of the map yet.
Yeah, it's been back and forth at the start of this game, and when we were talking about Kimbo at the start here, I saw him off. Oh my God, Penguin! Forget Kimbo! Penguin is going off right now. What a dirty shot there. But he's finally going to be taken down by one of the Fabi players. And Elevate have a lead here, just of two, but they seem to be getting a little bit of control of the map there, and all sparked by that disgusting no-scope from Penguin. So Calm now putting great shots onto one of the Fabi players across map now. No, there's a player pushing under him, bottom of the SMG, down on Engine 1. He's got his AR out. He's just walking around and communicating to his teammates where he's seeing some players at the moment. Speed jumps out. He's going to be toast, I believe. If he can get away, that'll be huge. But Calm says, my friend, you do not jump out onto the plat. If I've got an AR and I'm looking at you, I'm going to clean you up, no problem. And Swift Kill has the camo, and the sniper rifle is in the hands of Elevate as well. Everything is looking quite rosy for them right now, strong side.
All right, let's actually hop on board with Calm. You know what? Let's stay on board with Swift Kill. He's got camo and scatter. This is incredible play. Nice move by him, just staying alive. Doesn't need to do too much with camo and scatter. You got a pretty big advantage going up 1v1 against anyone else. Looks like they're going to open up the spawns here in this back corner, though. You see Swift Kill knows a player probably spawned back here as he makes his way back. Yep, a player spawned back here. He's going to pick up Monkey. Nope, teammate's going to finish him. There could possibly be another player. Yes, he's going to spot him. Kimbo and Doodle spotted down at Tower 1. Nice job by Swift just leaving him. He's going to let Calm Mentality possibly pick up the kill. Calm does. He does pick up Doodle. Rain is taken down, though. So there is a lead of 22-14 right now. They're holding this back corner and seemingly just letting the Fab E just spawn outside and not really giving them a chance to really push inside. Speed does have the sniper. Can he make this happen? Yes! Pulling off the double kill. Swift Kill now has the sniper rifle in hand. big plays from Swiftkill. I like to see that type of play as well, just staying alive, waiting for teammates, cutting corners, just doing everything you can to buy as much time as you possibly can. Swiftkill, the all-around player on this team.
You make big plays, you get big presence in the form of a sniper rifle, and Swiftkill seems to be just going off at the moment. That play with the scatter shot has created a huge opening, and a lead has definitely developed. But Doodle now answers back for Fabi with that snipe. And Calm's going to be here at the moment. He's going to be charged by Kimbo. Kimbo backs off smartly there, doesn't want to give away any deaths at the moment. It's such a close game, and Karma's going to find two players here, but Kimbo gives him a no scope to the face. Kimbo with another kill with a sniper rifle. Kimbo is going off right now, and he picks up a triple kill. Kimbo, stop it, my friend. You are not human.
He wanted to go for that overkill. You saw him pushing out for it. He wanted it, but Speed is going to pick up the sniper now, looking to pick up a kill. Not going to be able to. He's getting shot from everywhere, but Kimbo taking faces right now. They're trying to make their comeback. They're only down by four now. They have the advantage. Sniper in their hand with four shots. Going for a no scope. Not going to be able to pick it up. Doodle is at top tower, but Kimbo is right there, ready to help out Speed, or pick up Speed sniper. Kimbo back with the sniper. He sees players on his radar. Picks up one kill. Two players below. Going for the no scope. Doesn't need to actually help his teammates out at all. They both won their individual fights. Speed and Monkey really doing some work. 25 to 28. This is still a very close match. Sniper will be up soon. What Kimbo did right here, perfect play. I'm gonna kind of break this down. Kimbo noticed that there was no one on his team blocking that back corner spawn.
Yeah.
That opens up a spawn for someone on Elevate to spawn there. And a player did. He threw a grenade, he got hit ticks, he knows a player is back there. All players came back and collapsed and shut that player down.
Yeah, great place there. Great awareness from him, but I think he got a little bit overzealous from that triple kill and poked out when he was finally taken down, but Rain does have that sniper rifle in his possession now. And a four-kill game at the moment. Speed does close him down, so it just seems at the moment neither team, once again, he's been back and forth this entire game. Neither team has had control. Speed here misses a few shots. Penguin comes in with the AR, takes him down, and Penguin is the man of the moment and is making some openings here for Elevate as Swiftkill moves in and finishes off the kill that he started on Doodle. So Penguin doing a great job here for his squad. The six-kill lead is looking good for them at the moment. The weapons will be coming up in just 10 seconds, so whoever gets that sniper in their hands has just been doing ridiculous things with it at the moment as Swiftkill picks up a kill on Speed. He's actually going to be chased down though by Doodle, who finishes off that kill, but Swiftkill has a little present in his hand, and if he can use it like anyone else in this match has, I'm going to get overexcited.
And Camo is coming up right now. It should be up, and you see Swiftkill getting ready for it. I mean, he's got a dirty combo right now. He's got Scattershot, Camo, and Sniper Rifle. I mean, this is the best combo you could have on this map right now.
As Sims would call it, the Predator Combo.
The Predator Combo by Sims. Goes for the snipe, misses the snipe. Swiftkill still alive, though. He doesn't need to worry. He's got a lot of Camo left right now. He gets, once you pick up Camo, you get 45 seconds of Camo. So 45 seconds of invisibility is quite a good amount of time.
Oh!
Swiftkill with the no scope. Just making it look so easy. Just slowly just moving the snipe, picking up another headshot. Swiftkill showing why he is dominant with the sniper, bringing this team to the victory, 45 to 31. And if you can hear that beeping sound, that means the camo is running out. He doesn't have much camo left, and there, his camo has run out. He's gonna lose sniper, gonna lose scattershot, but you know what? It is 47 to 32. They don't need to worry. They pretty much have this game won, and some would say, charge because we can't lose in this point. So you're going to see a lot of these guys, Rain making a push, this guy making a push, but Kimbo picking up a double kill. Let's hop on board. He's like, you know what? No, this is not over, guys. Yeah, we're down by a lot. Yeah, you only need three kills, but we are going to bring this back. Nice job staying alive right there by Doodle. Every kill and every death matters right now at this point. They need to not give up a single death. Kimbo trying to stay alive.
Oh, Monkey
picking up a headshot here, trying to bring these guys back in the game. Only down by 10 kills now. Slowly and surely bringing these guys back. What they need to focus on next.
Oh,
another snapshot by Monkey.
What is going on?
What are we seeing from the B-Stream right now? Hashtag B-Stream hype, let's go in the Twitch chat. This stuff is crazy. It's been crazy all day. 39 to 48, only down by 9. Camo is coming up. If they can pick up this camo, we could see a potential comeback. No, they're going to get the kill for the 49th kill. Loses sniper. This is going to be a very hard comeback to have happen. 49 to 40, 41 to 49. Doodle looks like he's going to be taken down. And Elevate is going to take game number two to take or to lead the series 2-0. But the snipes we are seeing on set are unreal.
Strong side.
HWC worthy, without
a
doubt.
That was like the magic. That sniper rifle was possessed. Whoever touched it was just no scoping, quick scoping, double kills. It was just unbelievable.
I think that might have been an auto headshot sniper.
Yeah, we're going to have to get that looked into. I mean, that was unnatural sniping from some of these guys. Some of the shots they were hitting there, it was just so easy for them as well. I mean, we saw it from pretty much every single player on both sides. It wasn't any particular player. We saw Swift Kill going off with it. We saw Calm going off with it. Monkey. We saw Kimbo. Unbelievable plays from this.
Swift Kill.
Swift Kill, man. 20-8, Mike. Take us through these stats.
I mean, that's all that we need to talk about right there. Swift Kill, 20 kills. We've been saying this guy's the all-around player. He slays. He does objective. He gets assists. He controls power-ups. He controls power weapons. He's leading the charge for his team. He is just doing absolutely everything. I mean, look at this guy. Just so calm and collected right now.
Yeah, 28-8. No
Got a little smile right there. He's watching what's going on at the other side of the venue right now. Everyone is just so hyped right now. There's a Griffball promo going on right now. People just ground pounding people everywhere. But, man, B-Stream hype for real.
B-Stream, I mean, it's been a highlights package. It literally has. I mean, this is the first day. We haven't even reached, like, the end of the day, we're nowhere near it, and it has been a pure highlights package. We have seen a ninja, we have seen an overkill, we have seen some disgusting sniping in this series. We've seen a 49-49 over.
If you want to see montage gameplay,
B-Stream, man.
Let's stick to the B-Stream
here. B-Stream, baby.
We got it.
We're
got
here
everything.
All day. Unbelievable stuff, Mike.
A lot of stuff going on here. We're going to have game number three coming up next between these guys, and I think game number three, let's take a look. Strongholds on Eden. So what do you think? We're at 2-0 Elevate right now. It's got to be hard for Fabby right now to think that they can make this comeback, but they need to. They struggled in these past two game types. They need to leave those behind, focus on Strongholds Eden, because we've seen a lot of crazy things happen on Strongholds.
Yeah, we have. You're right.
We've already seen the 96-96, but in all seriousness, Strongholds is a game type where any comeback is possible. You could have a team up by 90 points, 80 points. There is always a chance for a comeback, and especially with all the stuff that's going on this map, there's rockets, there's overshield, and there's camo.
I mean, you're quite right. I mean, this is Fabby obviously needs to take this game to get back into the series. My only worry for Fabby right now, we have seen some incredible individual highlights. However, when it's come down to teamwork, and Strongholds is such a teamwork-orientated map, sometimes they've been a little bit behind in this Elevate squad. The Elevate squad have seemed to click together, so that's my fear. I feel like Elevate could close out the series right now, if I'm totally honest with you, just from what we've seen from the Fabby side on their teamwork sort of thing. But, I mean, if all of these Fabby players go off with the individual skill that we've seen on display already, it's anyone's game.
Yeah, definitely. And we actually saw the three-cap strat happen earlier in a few of the matches that were played. There you've got Doodle on your screen. We're going to be hopping on board with Rain to start the match here. All teams are going to be going for the rockets here at the start of the match. We're on board with Rain. He's looking across, picking up Blue Ben, trying to get shots on Speed. Speed just flying in right now. Stays alive. Nice job by Speed staying alive right there. Rain's going to pick up Blue Ben. No one on Fab to pick up a stronghold yet. Normally, you want to pick up Red Nest at least by this time, but still no capture yet. You see Speed trying to pick up a kill on Zane over on the Blue Ben side, but not able to do so. Kimbo making a good flank. He's going to sneak up behind this player, Swift Kill, and pick up. No,
he is eventually.
He is able to do that. Thought Swift Kill was going to do something dirty. Let's hop on board with Penguin, though, who has the rockets.
Yeah, Kimbo actually made a great play at the start of that game. He got the overshield, picked up a double kill, and secured the catwalk. But Penguin with those rockets, man, he's just coming in and cleaning out Red Nest. He's going to be hopping in this stronghold, trying to capture that for his squad. Finds a little bit of a ghost rocket there on Speed. Speed manages to dodge out of the way of that one and push Penguin back into the red bend, but Calm comes in. He cleans up the kill on Speed, so it's going to be Elevate in control of the map at the moment. Two strongholds in their control. Great shots across map on Kimbo, and it just seems like Elevate. You can see the team shot there, that was clicking, and if their teamwork starts working just like it is now, this could be curtains potentially in this game for Fab E.
Fab really needs to turn this around. It's still early in the game, but they need to get some control of the power-ups. The power-ups will be coming up at about 9:50, 9:55 when they were picked up. So if they can get control of an overshield and a camo, it makes it a lot easier to turn this game around. But real quick rundown of strongholds. You need to be capturing two strongholds to at least be getting some points. If you have one stronghold, you will not be getting any points. Oh. And then also, if you have one player in the stronghold, it takes 10 seconds to capture. That's a long time. But the more players you have in the stronghold, the less amount of time it takes. So having two players in the stronghold will take 6 seconds. Three players will take 4.5 seconds. And then four players will take 4 seconds. You're going to see a lot of players go for the two-player cap, knocking that capture time down by 4 seconds. 4 seconds is a lot of time that can change a lot within a game. Doodle picking up the overshield, though. This is what Fab needs to do, is get these power-ups. We were just saying he looks like he's going to capture Red Nest. You see on the kill feed, Monkey from Fab has the rockets as well. So they're getting control of the power-ups and power weapons, and now going for the three cap here. Doodle's going to need to stay alive. He knows he can't just capture that without getting severely injured. So he's doing a good job at making himself a hard kill and getting some help from his teammates right now. He's going to stay alive in the tower as he's getting some cover fire, but still they have yet to score a single point yet, and Doodle is taken down on set.
Yeah, and it just seems at the moment that the 100-point club is beckoning. So Fabi right now, as Khan picks up a double kill, and he's going to be trying to take total control here for Elevate, as he also has one rocket left in his hands. Great trigger discipline there, decided not to shoot that rocket. Uses the light rifle to help Swift kill out with that kill on Doodle. And yeah, they're doing a great job of holding down the trip cap. Great shots with the light rifle there. Perfect shots, even better than great. Perfect shots there, and he still... Mikey still has that rocket, so if anyone comes around that corner, he's gonna just blow them into the field.
And right now they're forcing the spawns over at tower, and looks like actually now they've opened up the blue spawn. So you see, you can tell where the players are set around the map. No one was over on the blue side from Elevate, so that allows Fab to spawn over on that side of the map. You see a lot of players kind of predicting where the other players are going to be because they know how the spawns work. Calm picking up a nice rocket kill, trying to stay alive. Some incredible footwork there from Calm. He's going to be taken down, but you know what? Swift kills right there. He's going to get ready to capture this and go back for the three-peat here on Blue Bend.
Yeah, Penguin here, he's going to be pushing in as well, because that rocket launcher coming up in just 3 seconds here. Again, we've seen Elevate players with the light rifle in their hands for so much of this game, just putting down shots across the map. And Mike, the light rifle, as you know, the weapon, you can do so much damage at long range so quickly, so so important to do that. And he has the rocket launcher on it. Looks like at the moment he's setting up for that new OS, and Penguin is loaded right now, Mike. This is not good if you are a Fab E fan right now. Takes down speed, knows there's another player bottom mid. He's going to have
long range.
Rick and Willie Hale, he gets a hit marker, but doesn't get the kill. But, I mean, 81-5, at least they're not going to be in the 100-point club, Mike. So, Fabi, they're going to be happy with that, at least.
Nice little dodge there from Penguin on that plasma pistol, though. Still has rockets and overshield. Looking to pick up a double. Does he pick it up? Yes, he does. Still in control of two. Going back for the three cap. All right, so players, you see them spawning all the way in that back blue corner because that spawn was open. That's probably one of the best places you could have the other team spawn because it's the longest route to get to another stronghold. They're still three capping, 95-5. It's not looking good for Fab right now. They have to capture two, and that's just not possible. Elevate is gonna take game number three, ending the series 3-0, and looking very solid, might I say.
Yeah, they look really convincing there. I was really, really impressed with Elevate in this series. I said at the start of the series, I fancied Fab E in that series. We saw some great individual plays from them, but their teamwork was just not on the same level as Elevate, as we saw in that Strongholds game. They had complete power-up control. They had power weapon control. They had everything you want to do in a Strongholds game, especially on Eden, those light rifles. I mean, they were just lighting up Fab E for the whole game.
Yeah, we saw the three shot from, what was it? I think it was Rain? Yeah, I think it was Rain, or no, it was Penguin at the end. We saw the three shot with the light rifle.
Yeah.
When you zoom in with the light rifle, if you get three shots while zoomed in, that is a three shot kill. And then from hip fire, not zoomed in, that is a four shot kill. So you want to use that zoom in feature with the light rifle to get a little bit more damage. But let's take a look at the stats. Penguin this time reigning the leaderboards here for most kills on the squad, 19-4. Definitely Fab E really getting outslayed in this match, and it's really hard to win a Strongholds match when you're not alive to capture a Stronghold.
Absolutely. I mean, if you're in Death Screen, you're not going to be able to do any objective work whatsoever, and you've got to give a massive shout out there to Penguin. 19-4 in a quick Strongholds game. I mean, that was a quick Strongholds game, Mike. So to get 90 kills in that period of time, he was just destroying, and I think it was probably because he had a Rockets a lot of the time as well.
And there you have it. There is the series score. Elevate taking all three games to end the series 3-0. Coliseum, they've won 3-2. The Rig Team Slayer, we saw Swift Kill just go off.
That was a crazy game.
50-41. Swift Kill dropped 20 kills. And then Eden Strongholds, 100-5. Elevate making quick work of Fab E there.
Yeah, really impressed there from Elevate. And, yeah, I mean, 3-0, they deserve that. And they, you know, we. But I've got to give the German boys a few shout-outs there. Kimbo, and he just went wild with the sniper on the Rig. That Rig game for individual plays, that was a tournament's worth of individual plays, wasn't it?
Exactly.
I mean, it was crazy. It was the magical sniper. If we see that again come out this tournament, I'll be pretty happy, to be honest. The magic sniper.
We've got one match left here tonight coming up next, but we're going to cut to a commercial break. Actually, two matches, sorry. Got the guy in my ear telling me we have two matches left. So two matches left tonight, and then we'll be back, though. So we're going to cut to a commercial break. We'll still be right here. #StreamB here.
B-Squad.
B-Squad hype. Let's go. We'll see you soon.